Hey guys. So today I will be doing a story time or like explanation or something like that video about the huge scar I have on my arm. Ever since I posted my tattoo explaining video, people have been asking me countless questions about it, and I promise that I'm going to do a full dedicated video to it. So this is the video. I wanted to sit down and record it for quite some time now, but I just wasn't feeling like sharing this story with the internet. But I feel like I put myself out there, and yeah, I think maybe some people can take something from this story or something like that. So I decided to share it. I won't be, if this is a trigger warning, if you're sensitive to anything about mental health and struggling in life and stuff like that, I don't think this would be a video for you. And I will be showing my scar on screen on pictures as well, so if you don't want to see pictures of scars or self-harm or anything like that, then this video might also not be for you. I won't be showing, I will like tell you before I'm going to show any pictures, because I'm not going to be showing the scar on this video because I got it covered a week ago. So it's right here. But you can't see it whatsoever, so I'm going to show a picture now. This is how it looked like before. It's a little bit healed on this picture, but it's still pretty much a fresh like scar. And yeah, this story happened in March, I think. Yeah, March of this year. And I've been really in a really, really dark place mentally for a few months at that point. And I was going regularly to a psychiatrist, but it wasn't really helping. I feel like my medicine wasn't really helping as well. I was struggling with depression, and I was struggling with an eating disorder, binge eating disorder. For anyone wondering, I was like, every emotion I had, I just had to eat and eat. If I was happy, I was eating. If I was unhappy, I was eating. And then I would stop eating for a long time, and then I would eat again, and I gained so much weight, and I was so unhappy with myself. I was feeling miserable every day. I wasn't going to school, so obviously like everything was struggling, my grades, my social life. So I, like, 3 years prior to this story, I was self-harming. I cut myself, but never really like helped me or anything, so I wasn't doing it now. But I like tried it a couple of times, it didn't help, so I thought like, okay, I might like be depressed or something, but at least I like have everything under control, nothing bad will happen to me because I'm not like self-harming or I'm not doing anything. The only bad thing that I'm doing is basically not going to school and not hanging out. I low-key stopped going to a psychiatrist on the regular. I was like flicking it off. I thought I was so strong and like handling everything by myself. And at this point I had new medication that I was given, and there was a very, very very like dangerous, but like not, it was like just like a physical danger, not a psychological danger. So I was like, okay, like I wasn't going to drink anyway. I didn't drink for a very long time at this point, but my friend invited me to like go out and like go clubbing and stuff like that, and I didn't hang out with people for like such a long time. So I was like, okay, I'm going to push myself and like hang out. So I went, and like for maybe 2 days prior to this I did not take the medication so that I could drink, which is like so stupid and you should totally not do. And yeah, I went out and I started drinking at like 7 p.m. and everything was fine. I was having fun. Then we went to the club and we're just like dancing, having fun, drinking some more. And at this point everything was like perfect. I was like super happy. I was with my friends, and some of our friends left, and this was quite like pissed me. this point I was completely sober. I unbandaged my arm and I looked at what I did and I was horrified. I was like so disgusted. It was, I'm not going to go into detail, I haven't looked, but it was so disturbing. So I went to like the living room and my grandma was there. My mother was, I don't know where she went, like somewhere outside. And I was like, I was